The Leon Valley Railroad was created on November 8, 2001 after the Leon Pacific and Colson Valley Railroad merged to make LVLR. For the most part, they had barely any bad accidents, but however, 10 years after LVLR was created, they would have their first major accident. On May 25th, 2012, at 8 p.m., LVLR Lumber Train M-SPC-CHA-25 was traveling from Spring Creek Yard in Joliet, Illinois, down to Champaign, Illinois. This train had 7 empty center beams and 1 locomotive pulling the train. The locomotive pulling the train was LVLR C-40-8-1336, which was an XLEP locomotive. There were 2 crew members on this train, who were 42-year-old engineer Alan Johnston and 36-year-old conductor Alex Bennett. The crew were instructed to drop off the center beams at a lumber mill in Champaign so they could be loaded and taken to another lumber mill down south in Charleston, Illinois. Just north of Champaign in the small town of Paxton, the crew decided to just tie the train down. They literally just stopped the train and left it there. This would play a crucial part later on. Meanwhile, back at Joliet, an LVLR manifest, M-SPC-NCH-25, was traveling from Spring Creek Yard down to Nankana Yard in Memphis, Tennessee. 3 locomotives were on this train. The locomotives were OVLR AC-44-6697, which is also an XLEP, SD-40-2, 928, which was an XCVRC, and there was a DPU at the rear of the train, and an SC-70M number 2195. This train had 3 crew members who were 46-year-old engineer Marcus Jones, 39-year-old conductor Frank Ruiz, and 23-year-old brakeman Hudson Harris. Not long after they left the yard, they went to standard 55 miles an hour down the track. Up ahead, it showed that there was a green signal indicating that the line was clear and that they could go faster. At 10:06 p.m., they started to near the sleepy town of Paxton, Illinois. Up ahead, Marcus Jones started to notice something yellow reflecting off the lights of his locomotive. Marcus realizes that's another train, and then he slams on the brakes, and they all jump from the fast-moving train, and then it happens. The manifest rear-ends the lumber train at 10:11 p.m. 5 of the 7 center beams from the lumber train derail, and both of the front locomotives and 6 cars in the manifest derail as well. The nearby town of Paxton was awakened by the loud sound of crushing steel and metal. The crew from the lumber train were blamed for the crash due to them being negligent and not letting dispatch know that they had stopped on the main line. However, they were not the only ones at fault. For about a couple days already, the signals along that line had been malfunctioning and no trains were instructed to go onto that line until May 25th. However, LVLR did manage to make a temporary fix to the signals, but it clearly did not work on all signals on that line, as the green signal that the manifest passed should have been red. After the accident, the crew who were on the lumber train were fired from LVLR, and the crew who bailed from the manifest only suffered minor injuries. In the end, LVLR 6697 and LVLR 928 were damaged beyond repair and scrapped. 2195 was put back into service and continues to operate to this day. LVLR 1336, the locomotive leading the lumber train, was also put back into service, and it would be retired from LVLR in 2018, and later sold in 2021 to the Potosi and La Crosse Railroad, a regional railroad based out of western Wisconsin, and it was renumbered to 1463, and it continues to operate as of late 2022. All 5 of the derailed center beams were scrapped along with the 6 derailed cars on the manifest. Marcus Jones, the engineer of the manifest, would continue to work for LVLR for a couple more years before retiring in 2019. Brakeman Hudson Harris and conductor Frank Ruiz continue to work with LVLR to this day. It has been 11 years since this incident, and now, malfunctioning signals aren't really as common anymore, and LVLR does continue to have major accidents, such as a recent incident involving a loaded LVLR crude oil train and an MWP coal train. But that is a story for another video. So what is the lesson to learn from this wreck? Never, ever tie your train down on the main line, or else it could lead to very catastrophic results. Thank you guys so much for watching.